plantains come in all shapes and sizes. These particular plantains are called panaplátanos, at least here in Puerto Rico. They're a lot fatter and squatter than the usual plantain that you see around. And today we're going to make what's called tostones. These particular tostones, made with panaplátano, taste like a combination of plantain and breadfruit, which gives it kind of a lighter, fluffier kind of textured taste. So I hope you enjoy this. This is going to take a few steps, so watch carefully. I'm going to first start with peeling one of these. You got to get them very green. So that you get that nice starchy effect. Once they turn ripe or black on the outside, they're good for making like a sweeter dish. But this is going to be more of a salty, starchy kind of thing. So let's see how this works. So take one of these. Take these peels off. Throw those away, you don't need that. Now, we're going to go to the next step, which is taking these things and creating some thick slices. I actually prefer doing it diagonally like that. And then you take all this and you put it in some water. See how thick they are? See? And then the water, I add some salt. Peel there. These sliced panaplátano plantains have been sitting in salt water for about an hour or two. Now let's take these over and take them to the next step, which is the fun part, which is the frying. Alright? Here we go. And we're going to put these to fry in the first fryer. As the first two frying stages. When they get kind of golden, they'll be ready to take out. You can squish them with anything you want. I use this. Like that. Like that. Nice, huh? Nice and big. These are going to taste real good. I'm going to fry them again. As you can see, the tostones are now golden brown, so it's time to put them on the bounty sheet. And they're going to be really yummy. Yummy! All golden, lightly brown, and all it needs is a little special attention. You could use this really garlicky butter with a little parsley and salt that kind of warmed up back there. And you can put some of these here. Or you can take my famous ají, the old Colombian recipe that I learned from watching in the kitchens, different homes.